Hello everyone, and welcome to IKC Danish. Hej alle sammen, og velkommen til IKC Dansk. I dag skal vi snakke om cyklen. In Danish, a bicycle is called en cykel. And we're going to learn some of the words about things on the bicycle. En cykel har to hjul. To hjul. Two wheels. Bicycle has two wheels. In Danish, hjul. You don't say the H, it's silent, so it's just jul. Same word as Christmas, except for the spelling. Then we have other things. The body of the bicycle, so this black one. Mine has stars on it. That is called stellet. Stellet. It stell. Stellet. Yeah. So that's like the body of it. Then we have the seat. You can just say sæde, that means seat. But usually on a bicycle we would say sædel, en sædel. That means a saddle, like on a horse, right? Because it's an iron horse. We love our iron horses in Denmark. Then we have the steering wheel here, which is not a wheel, so not sure what it's called in English, but in Danish it is et styr. Et styr. Yeah. Jeg styrer cyklen. I control the bicycle. Then we have these lights. This one is at the front, so it is called en forlygte. So it's just en lygte. That means a lamp, a torch, sort of. A handheld lamp, that's en lygte, right? So a lamp that is stationary is en lampe. And a lamp that you carry around or bring around with you, that is en lygte. Det en forlygte, because it's at the front. It's a front light. We have one at the back too. En baglygte. Baglygte. Yeah. Den sidder bag på. You see, we don't pronounce behind the same way. So if it's in a word, if we say bag and then put it with lygte, then it becomes baglygte. We do that sometimes, then it changes how we say it. On a bicycle, we have something that makes the wheels go around. That is this one. This bugger here. Den hedder en kæde. En kæde. En cykelkæde. And you know, when you go on your bicycle, sometimes if you go over a bump or something and this is loose, then it will jump off back here or over here. And you have to put it back on again. And that is called kæden hopper af. Yeah, so the chain jumps off. Kæden hopper af. Okay? Right. So, these for your feet that make the chain go around. This is called en pedal. En pedal. To pedaler. Pedalerne. Yeah? Alright. Then we have this one. These look different from bike to bike, but you see it has room for a key, because you can lock it. This is a lock. Det en lås. En cykellås. Right, so we can just put bicycle in front of it, and then it's a bicycle thing. So, bicycle lock is en cykellås. En cykelkæde. Et cykelhjul. Yeah? So you just put bicycle in the front, and it's always one word. Okay. Then we have this little thing. This is not a light. It's just something that reflects light. Yeah? In Danish we call it en reflex. En reflex. Because it reflects light. It makes sense. We also call them et katteøje. So a cat's eye. And that's because cats' eyes tend to reflect light. So in the dark, if you see a cat and you have some light, then the eyes will pop out. Now, then we have this one, right? Det en ringeklokke. En ringeklokke. Because it's a bell and it rings, so it's a ring bell. That's quite logical, right? And you need one of these, just as you need the lights, in order for your bicycle to be legal in Denmark. You can get a fine if your bicycle doesn't have the required things. So you can find a list online. This is a brake, and some bicycles have only these brakes for your hand, but a lot of bicycles in Denmark have them down here for your feet as well. And they are both called en bremse. En bremse. Right, so you get that nice R as if you're trying to get a booger out of your mouth, right? And this one is called en håndbremse. So it's a handbrake, right? And if it's down here, it is en fodbremse. Right, so it's a foot brake. It makes sense, right? It's just a brake for your hand, a brake for your foot. Then we have this thing. This one carries your luggage, whatever you need to bring around with you. And it's usually on the back. Some bicycles have it in the front as well. Either way, it is called en bagagebærer. It's a little long. En bagagebærer. Bagage, that's luggage, and bærer, with an R at the end, that is a carrier. So it carries your luggage, right? That makes sense. Og på min bagagebærer en cykelkurv. So on my luggage carrier, I have a basket. En cykelkurv. We don't say the V as a normal V, we just say kurv. Sounds a little funny. Yeah. What else? We also have these. And these protect your legs that go here from all the mud that your wheels will bring around. This is called en skærm. En skærm. So a screen, right? Because it screens off the wheel. En cykelskærm, you could say. And they are at both ends. This one here as well. Mm-hmm. Then we have these ones that make the chain go around. See, it has little teeth around there. It's like clockwork. In Danish, these things that make chains go around in the machine are called tenhjul. Tenhjul. Right, you know which one I'm talking about? It's this one in here. In there. Yes. Then we have a nice modern invention. That's the gears, right? So you can change your gears here. And then you get to choose how hard it's going to be. Mm? In Danish, we just took the English word just completely solely. So we say et gear. Et gear, right? Because that's just a gear. And we don't really call this thing anything. Not normally, we just say gear changer, en gearskifter, right? At skifte gear, that's to change gears. Ja, at skifte gear. Nu har jeg vendt cyklen om. I turned my bicycle around. At vende om, that is to turn around. Because I want to show this. Nu har jeg vendt cyklen om. I turned my bicycle around. At vende om, that is to turn around, because I want to show this one. This one we call a support foot. En støttefod, because it helps the bicycle stand, so it supports it, and it's like a foot, right? En støttefod. We don't say bicycle in front of this, we just say støttefod. Now, I almost forgot a very important thing. It's not on the bicycle, but it should belong with it. This one. This one is called en cykelhjelm, a bicycle helmet, or just en hjelm. And if you go around on a bicycle or on roller skates or something, skateboard, you should always wear one. Because even though a helmet might mess up your hair, the ground might mess up your face, right? So be careful. And even though a lot of Danish people don't use them, you should do it, because sometimes us Danish people can be a little stupid, and when we don't put on a helmet, that's one of those times that you shouldn't listen to us, but listen to your senses. Thank you for listening. Stay safe, stay beautiful. God bless. See you.